Oh no, Microsoft added a new hardware requirement, and this time you can't bypass it. Before you get out your pitchforks though, this is not actually a big deal, and it's only for really old CPUs, much older than the previous hardware requirements that people were getting upset about a few years ago. So what is going on? Well, it turns out that in one of the more recent Windows Insider pre-release builds, there is indeed a new hardware requirement, and for example, if you try to do an upgrade or run the upgrade tool thing, it will tell you, at least if you don't have support for this, it says this PC's processor doesn't support a critical feature, PopCNT. And what that's referring to is a CPU instruction called population count. Now, CPU instructions I can go over a bit later, but basically it's just an ability or feature of the processor at like the hardware level. And it's actually a very old instruction that was created back in the 60s and was added to pretty much every CPU starting around 2007, 2008. And what's different about this requirement is you can't simply bypass it like you could the previous ones that had requirements on CPU generation. You can still do the bypass command and techniques, it's just that Windows simply will not be able to boot regardless. It'll just freeze, apparently. The person on Twitter who seemingly discovered this initially also posted a list of a bunch of binaries that apparently require this CPU instruction. I'm not sure exactly how he determined this, but here's what he put. So it does seem at least that this is a true hardware requirement, and it is actually something that is being used in Windows and is important enough where it simply won't work without it. And the reason I and most other people seem to not think this is anything worth getting mad about is that obviously, computers change over time. You're not going to be able to support every piece of hardware forever, and this is a very old feature. So it turns out this was actually added in an instruction set called SSE4. That's short for Streaming SIMD Extensions 4, and SIMD stands for Single Instruction Multiple Data. Again, basically just a set of CPU features that are incorporated into the CPU at hardware level. The first generation of Intel CPUs to integrate these features was the microarchitecture Nehalem. Not sure if that's correct. In 2008, and specifically in Intel, they call this the SSE4.2. And also an easy way to tell is that this was the first Intel Core CPU series. So if you have an Intel Core i5, i7, i anything, your CPU does support this. With AMD, this was any CPU that had the K10 microarchitecture, which started in 2007. Now, if you want to see for sure, specifically if a CPU has support for this, there are a couple ways. One is to use the program CPU-Z, it's freeware, and when you run that and just go to the first CPU tab for Intel CPUs, you can look for the instructions box and then look for SSE4.2. Or for AMD, you can look for SSE4A. Or if you want to use a tool that's more official, you can use the Core Info tool that is part of Microsoft's SysInternals suite. So you simply download that and run the command coreinfo-f, it stands for features. And then I believe for both AMD and Intel, it should say PopCNT somewhere in that list as its own entry, and that should clue you in as well. But rest assured, if you were able to install Windows 11 or upgrade to it without having to do any special workarounds, obviously you'll be fine. And even if you did have to do a workaround, unless it's an extremely old CPU, like a Core 2 Duo or something like that, you won't have to worry about it. Now, what exactly is this population count instruction? Well, at the risk of sounding too technical, it simply counts the number of one bits set in a so-called machine word. And a word is simply a certain number of defined bits. For example, in a 64-bit CPU, which is what most of you, almost all of you will be using, a word is 64 bits long. That's what that means. So if you have a big 64-bit word like this and there's only one in there, then the population count would be one. Apparently, this can also be referred to as the Hamming weight in certain contexts. I did read through a post or article by someone, I'm gonna butcher this name, I'm so sorry, it's Vaibhav Sagar, and they clearly know much more about this than I ever could, and they listed many possible use cases for this, including what I noticed specifically was cryptography and neural networks. And those caught my eye because we already know that Microsoft, as part of their previous new Windows 11 hardware requirements, were the TPM modules. That's the reason, basically, they supported only certain generations of Intel and AMD CPUs, was because they had certain cryptography features in there, so that could be building upon that. So they're adding possibly even more cryptography security features into Windows 11 that simply require this feature. And the other one mentioning neural networks would make sense if Microsoft is trying to push AI features. Maybe that's also part of it. They might be using that at some point. But in any case, remember, it does actually seem to be already being used in some binary files that they're using. So it's not like they're just making it future-proof. They kind of already need it for whatever reason at this build going forward. Now, you've heard me talk about CPU instructions and might be wondering what exactly that means. So you might know that CPUs are made up of a bunch of transistors, but it's not like they're just randomly placed on the CPU. These transistors are arranged in very special ways physically that have some pretty interesting properties that allow us to build computers. For example, if you arrange them in certain ways, you can create so-called logic gates, they're called, where, for example, with an AND gate, the second one will only activate if the first two are both activated, and then you can create logical tests and stuff using all those, and there's a whole bunch of these. And those aren't instructions, those are more building blocks, and then you can combine many, many, many of these logic gates to create special instructions. And that might be something like an addition instruction or multiplication instruction, or one that is very complicated and counts the number of bits in some memory address, which is what this does. And funny enough, I bet for many of you who played Minecraft and tried your hand at redstone, if you tried to make any kind of special contraptions, I'm almost sure that you read about logic gates or created some simple ones yourself. Anyway, CPUs have many of these instructions built into the CPU at a physical level, and they basically are put there to more efficiently do certain tasks. So they might have a bunch of different features or instruction sets that have to do with making it easier to do cryptography calculations and stuff like that. And sometimes, even if you don't have a specific instruction, you can use other ones to emulate it, it's called. And that's why you might be able to run, for example, a PS2 game on a computer, because you use an emulator that basically simulates the same CPU architecture that has all the other features the PS2 has on the computer, and that's why you're able to run it, kind of sandboxes it in a way. And I did find that a bit relevant because I did read on Reddit someone who said that they, I guess, worked in Microsoft on the console host or conhost.exe, and they had an interesting insight where they said that at least when they worked on it and in some of the binaries they checked, the binary or executables check to see the various features that a CPU has and will use different methods or pathways depending on those features. And he said that for at least one of them, it does actually check for population count, and if it doesn't see that, takes another pathway or another method. And what he was saying was this means that it doesn't necessarily guarantee that the population count requirement is the reason that Windows wouldn't boot. And if I had to guess, the thinking could be that, well, if they added these checks to use alternative methods for one of the binaries, it wouldn't make sense to only add that check for one of them if Windows 11 truly was going to require that CPU instruction, because it still wouldn't be able to boot without all the other ones supporting it. So that might suggest if one of them does a check and has alternatives, then the other ones might also be doing that, and that it could be something unrelated, just as a coincidence, that could be causing it to not boot with Windows 11. So he didn't check all of them, but that is a possibility. I guess we'll have to see about that. Or what's also possible is CPUs that old that don't support population count, there might be other features that the alternative paths are using, so some might support it, some might not be able to run Windows. Again, this is all speculation, just thinking out loud, but just gives you some things to think about. In any case, the main takeaway is that this doesn't really change anything for 99.9% of people. And if you do have to be running Windows 11 on a CPU that old, then it probably wasn't running very well anyway. And in that case, you might just want to like install Linux or something. I would be very curious to hear some of you though, are you running it on a CPU that old? Maybe you're running it on something lightweight like on Linux and you don't care about Windows 11. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to give it a big giant thumbs up for the YouTube algorithm. And if you want to subscribe, I try to make videos about twice a week, usually Wednesday and Saturday. If you want to keep watching, the next video I'd recommend is where I talked about some hidden Chrome flag settings that you might want to consider changing depending on your preference. I'll put those right there. I've gotten some good feedback about that one, so I think you'll enjoy it. I'll put that link right there you can click on. So thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.